first game features two teams that have taken different paths so far this season. The Revolution come in at 7-0, where the Terps are in at 2-5 and struggling to make the playoffs. Will the Revolution's success continue towards perfection, or will the Terps get a must-win third win of the season? We'll find out next.
It's week 8 here in the PGBL. I'm Teddy Costins of Cosmos Philly, here with Fatih Yiannopoulos at St. Demetrius Greek Orthodox Church. Fatih, give us a little bit about tonight's matchup here. We've got the Revolution and the Terps. Give us the picture on the game.
Well, first, I just wanted to say Chronia Pola to everybody named Nico, Nicoleta, Nikki, and whatnot. Chronia Pola to all of you. As far as tonight's game, the Revolution have been a one-way freight train running over everybody so far. 7-0 and winning most of their games by double digits, just like they did last week against the Kings.
All right, what are the problems with the Terps this year?
They lack size. I mean, they have a decent amount of guard play with Niko Balis coming over from the Goya League. I mean, he's averaging over 20 points a game, but he's not really getting much help. Other guys need to step up, and they don't rebound the ball well. And the Revolution have some size, so they may be getting their fifth straight loss tonight.
Is there anything they can actually do to stop the Revolution from really just putting it to them?
Pray, pretty much. I mean, this matchup doesn't bode well for them. Hopefully, Niko and his Yorti can like drop 40 tonight. That's their only chance of winning. The Revolution are just too strong.
There you have it. Their game rests on a prayer. Let's see what happens. Well, when we called this game, Fatih and I, I said to Fatih, how could the Terps actually pull this off? And he said, on a prayer. And apparently that prayer has been answered. Two players thrown out of the game. They pulled it off with four players. Congratulations to the Terps. I'm going to go over to Nick here since it is his name day. Give us a few words about today's game, Nick.
We started playing team basketball again. I texted George this morning. I said, we got to get back to playing basketball. And that's what we did today. We came out, played as a family like we always did, and you see what happened.
Yep. All right, anybody else want to throw something into this?
Yeah, just a good all-around team effort. We fought with five guys, and I said before the game, I said, I have a weird feeling we're going to pull this one out. I said it to him, and we fought the whole game, and we kept our heads together when whatever was going on in that game, and that's the most important thing, and we stuck it out, and we all played well and fought hard.
Yeah, no, it was just like you said, a team effort. We played hard, and hustle and heart wins the game.
Mr. O'Hara? Looks like you sat it down and got to watch your teammates pull it out. What was it like sitting there watching that?
They're a fun group to watch, and so is the other team. Both teams played hard. It was a great game. Great game to watch.
And Mr. K over here, you antagonized the hell out of the Revolution.
I did.
What do you want to say about tonight's game?
Not much. I mean, I don't mean for it to get that out of control, but we play hard. We play with heart. And that's Terps basketball. It was last year, it is this year, and it's going to be next year.
There you have it. The Terps beating the number one ranked team, the Revolution. We'll see you at game two.
Tonight's spotlight game features a finals rematch from last season. The Warriors and Kings both coming in at 4-3, somewhat inconsistent so far this season. Who will end up in third place after tonight, and who will be 500? Tip-off is next.
Well, game two promises to be a little bit different. There's a great matchup here. The Kings and the Warriors. Fatih, what do you see?
Well, this is a rematch from last year's finals on February 23rd, which was a great game, and the Warriors pulled it out. And I've been waiting a really, really long time to get back at them.
Well, it's a game, I guess, of age versus beauty or age versus youth here. What can you guys do to actually pull out a victory? What do you need to do?
Well, we have to use our experience and our size. We're not going to outrun them. And we have to limit our turnovers because when they get out in the fast breaks, they get a lot of easy baskets. That's how they generate about 50% of their points. So if we can keep control of the ball like we did in the regular season game against them last year, we won by 9, we increase our chances of winning.
And obviously the game rests heavily on your shoulders, but who else are you depending on tonight to give you a lot of help?
Well, we need the entire team to step up. I know Bill, was struggling a little bit earlier in the season. Now he seems to have that touchback, and we definitely need him if we're going to make it back to the championship game. But everyone else, too. Chris Gurulaz had a few great games there. Last week it was a little under the weather, which kind of cost us against the Revolution, but we have eight guys, and everybody needs to step up, especially against the Warriors.
There you have it. Thanks, Fadu. Good luck tonight. I thought game one was incredible. Game two, just as good, if not better. Double overtime, the Kings beating the Warriors. Bill Zonias hit a three-pointer. I'm just going to go straight to Bill first. Bill, tell me, what were you thinking right after that three-pointer at the end of the first game?
I don't know. I really don't remember. I usually black out when that happens. So.
Good, I called the timeout, right, Bill?
Go ahead. Yeah, I didn't want him to call a timeout, but he did. So, we started after the timeout. We did a little inbound trick, and we threw a couple of the Warriors off. And I knew I was shooting it again, and I barely saw it go in. I think I looked between somebody's legs, and it just went right in the basket. So,
Fati, a little bit of exuberance there at the end of the first game, or was there more after you realized you were going to go into double OT?
Well, give credit to, the Warriors. They made us earn this win. We knew this was a big win for a big game for both of us. We didn't want to fall to 500 at the midway mark, and we lost to them in the championship game. But man, anybody that's prone to heart attacks should not watch our games. I mean, we don't like to make it easy on ourselves, but you know, Bill's really coming into his own now. I know he was struggling in the beginning of the season. He was getting good shots; they weren't falling. But now he's really coming into his own, and a lot of our opponents better watch out.
One more reflection question. Was there any thought about last year going into those huddles?
No. I put that behind me about a month after the game. It took me a month, but I put it behind me about a month after. I love all those guys. I love everybody, even if they don't like me. So they were saying some stuff to me, but you know what? I love them no matter what.
You had a lot of love on the court. Game two, definitely something to watch in the highlights. Stay tuned for game three. Congratulations, Kings.
Tonight's final matchup features the number two team in the PGBL, the Sixers, coming in at 5-2 against the Mavericks, who are 3-4. However, the Mavericks have won three out of their last four games, and a win tonight over the Sixers would definitely make them a title contender. Will they come out with a win? We'll find out next.
Well, game three seems to be a bit of a battle also. That you got the Sixers and the Mavericks. One team's holding on to second place. The other team seems to be resting in the middle pack. Fati, give us the picture of this game.
Well, with the Sixers, they're 5-2, obviously, in second place. And second place is very important this year, being the fact that the top two teams get the first round bye into the semifinals. So the Sixers are going to keep that gap over the third place teams, which are the Warriors and Kings right now. They're led by Tony Gramenos and Jim Armanakis, which average 45 points a game combined, which is 75% to 80% of the entire team. So the key is to try to stop those two players if you're going to beat them.
Give me a breakdown of the Mavericks tonight. Who looks like somebody we're going to have to keep an eye on?
Dimitri Poulimenos. He has been reborn this season, and especially the last four games where the Mavericks were 3-1. I mean, he went from averaging less than 10 points a game, and now he's averaging over 18 points a game. So he's been the big reason why the Mavericks have actually gotten back into the race and in the playoff hunt right now. So the Sixers are going to really, really going to have to focus on him because he can go off and score 30 at any moment.
Can you give us a prediction on tonight, on that game?
I'm gonna go with the Sixers. I just think that they have two guys that can score a lot of points, and I think it's going to be a pretty tight game. The Mavericks have shown me that they can compete with the best, but in the end, I like the experience of the Sixers to pull it out and move to 6-2.
Is momentum playing a role here between these two teams at all?
Well, the Mavericks had won three in a row, then they lost last week. The Sixers, they've won like two out of their last three. It seems like besides the Grizzlies, everybody has beaten everybody so far in this league. You have the Grizzlies that are winless, the Revolution that haven't lost a game yet, but anybody else can beat anybody on any given night. So I wouldn't be surprised if the Mavericks pulled this one out.
There you go. Any given night, anything can happen here at the PGBL.
I'm here with Steve Danulis and John Vasilio, members of the Sixers, winning the third and final game of tonight against the Mavericks. After two hard-fought games earlier in the night, this game was a lot more relaxing. It seems like you got out early and often. What was the game plan coming into tonight's game?
I don't know. The game plan was just to play well, I guess.
He is in a loss for words.
Yeah.
What did you guys discuss? What were you happy about in that first half where you built such a big lead?
We said to run the ball a lot, work the fast break, I guess. Yeah.
Well, you got the W and you're at 6-2. John, how would you, assess your team's performance in the first half of the season? 6-2, obviously a second best record in the league. Mm-hmm. If you can hold on to that, you would have a first round bye going into the playoffs, which obviously would be huge. So how would you assess everything so far?
But look, we want that first round bye, and we think it's really important because it's one less playoff game, you know what I mean? So right now we're 6-2, we're in second place. It's the halfway mark. We played everybody once. We're going to go back and play everybody a second time, and we hope to be one of the first two spots because we think it's important to position ourselves that way going into the playoffs.
It's probably going to be really intense the second time around. Since you won six out of your eight games, you're probably going to have a lot of teams want to get back at you the second time around.
Yeah, definitely. We know we got a lot of tough games coming up. Against the Mavs again, you know, the Mavs were shorthanded today. They were missing like three or four players, and they fought hard. But we know when we play them again, it's going to be a lot tougher. We know when we play all the other teams, it's going to be a lot tougher. There were two teams that beat us. Obviously, we won't revenge against those two teams. But we're moving along good, and, you know, we're happy where we are.
Well, they're only one game out of first place since the Revolution lost tonight. Congratulations to both of you and the rest of the team. And everybody have a great night.